I'm Alan, and I'm 20.
20. And you came today to protest the wars in Iran and Afghanistan. Why is this?
I don't know if I'm protesting. I guess I'm here just to see what's going on and what I think about it. And I'm trying to follow what's going on in Afghanistan and Iraq closely and try my best to understand it.
Personally, why do you get involved?
Why do I get involved? Because I'm against the war. I'm against the occupation of Afghanistan. We'll never win there. We're just losing our boys, same as we did in Iraq. Iraq was an unjust war. We didn't belong there in the first place.
Do you know anyone who has been in Iraq or Afghanistan or is there right now?
I know of a soldier that was sent there 3 times. Lives on Staten Island, New York. His mother is part of the Veterans Against the War.
What are his feelings about those conflicts?
Well, he felt as if he had to go because his friends went. He was misguided.
And what do you think this military machinery has so much power in this country?
Well, because they make money. They sell arms indiscriminately to all countries.
And meanwhile, many people are dying.
Absolutely.
Why do you get involved in this?
I've been involved for a long time, since 77 with Revolution Bookstores in Seattle. I came from Seattle today. And I believe that we need revolution. And I believe any struggle that can help transform people so they're ready to make revolution, I'm for that. And when you talk about the Iraq War, they don't talk about all the Iraqi people who died. They make them invisible, and it's just one of many crimes this empire has committed and will continue to commit until we get rid of it. So anything that takes steps in that direction, I am supportive of.
What would you tell those Americans who believe that the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan and all the military bases of the U.S. in the world are making these countries safer?
Well, I don't believe it makes it safer. I believe that they're making less safe, but anyway, even if it was making them safer, how can they have their safety on the blood of all the people?
What are your feelings about the wars going on over there?
Well, I think for sure we started them for absolutely the wrong reasons. That under the Bush people, they were initially conducted incompetently and for private interest.
Oh,
Do you think the future of this country is compromised because of the current wars? Wars in Iraq and Afghanistan?
In which way? We're building more enemies, especially in Afghanistan. And with the drones flying over and dropping on innocent people. So we're building enemies rather than saving a country.
Are you aware that the U.S. military has over 1,000 bases in the world?
Yes, of course. Uh-huh.
And they are just opening 7 new ones in Colombia and probably in Peru.
Uh-huh.
What do you think of that?
Well, I think it's wrong. It's imperialism. We're trying to take over the world. Let's take care of our citizens. Let's take care of people in our country. Let's pass a health care bill that helps everyone, not just the middle class or the upper class. What about all the poor people that don't have health insurance? And now that is off the table.
And you do all this out of your own effort. You
yes.
spend your time, your money, your energy.
Yes.
Are you going to continue doing this?
Absolutely.
Actually, I believe the slogan, transform the people to make revolution. I don't believe reform will do it. And I unite with people that resist different things. But I know that you cannot reform this bloody empire.
No peace! U.S. out of the Middle East! No justice! No peace! U.S. out of the Middle East, no justice, no peace. U.S. out of the Middle East, no justice, no peace. U.S. out of the Middle East, no justice, no peace. U.S. out of the Middle East, no justice, no peace.
Well, I've been long involved with the anti-war movement since 2003, since we invaded Iraq, and I believe that the wars and occupations are illegal, certainly weren't congressionally justified at any point, and personally believe that preemptive war is a faulty strategy for establishing peace around the world, which is what our country should be striving for. So that's why I'm here, that's why I'll always be here, that's why I'll be at the camp tonight, and that's why I'll continue this fight.
Do you expect to see more people coming out today?
Personally, yes. It looks like there's probably 5,000, I would guess around 5,000 here. Personally, I was hoping for in the neighborhood of 10,000, but I think this is a decent first step. I think we have a long way to go. The anti-war movement's been fractured on a number of fronts, particularly because Obama's in the White House and has the rhetoric to fracture such a movement. But I think we have an opportunity to establish ourselves, and I think this is a good first step.
You're wearing an Arab scarf.
I am, yes.
What's that for?
It's solidarity with a large group of friends that I have. Both in the real worlds and virtual worlds. I believe strongly that we have to seek solidarity around the globe in order to establish a peace movement that's viable and that will remain in place for a long, long time. So it's important to reach out to those brothers and sisters who may not naturally relate to me.
What do you tell those U.S. citizens who believe that these wars in Iraq and Afghanistan are making these countries safer?
Yeah, I've never understood that policy, and I'm not sure I ever will. I try to listen, I try to understand, and I try to question their realities. But I've never felt any less safe than I have in this particular time and place. Even when 9/11 occurred, and everything was sort of in a discombobulated mess here in the United States, immediately we were able to establish solidarity with countries around the world. Everyone felt sympathy for the United States. All that eroded upon the invasion of Iraq, and I can understand why. What I don't get though is this: why individuals, entities, organizations would not believe in continuing the occupations for the sake of peace in the homeland. It just doesn't make any sense.
Thank you. going to drop the trophies at the White House, not here at the VA. So that's my